Good morning, students. Welcome to our online class. So in today's class, we'll discuss leftover topics in Laplace transforms. Correct? Previously, in one video, I explained about Laplace transform formulas and properties of Laplace transforms and inverse Laplace transforms. How to solve inverse Laplace transform using partial fractions. Okay. So first shifting theorem. These all we covered in our first in previous video. Right. Now, in this video, I will going to explain convolution theorem. That means very, very important this convolution theorem. I mean, left out topic in Laplace transform. We left convolution theorem and applications to ordinary differential equation. Those topics we'll cover in this unit, right? So, without wasting time, see the definition of convolution theorem. What is the statement of convolution theorem? If L inverse of f bar of s is equal to f of t, if L inverse of f bar of s is equal to f of t and L inverse of g bar of s is equal to g of t. L inverse of g bar of s is equal to what? G of t. L inverse of g bar of s is equal to g of t. Then L inverse of what we need? F bar of s into g bar of s. L inverse of f bar of s into g bar of s will give you integral 0 to t. F of u into g of t minus u into du. L inverse of f bar of s into g bar of s is equal to what? Integral 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u du. Okay, very, very important ma, this is. So in inverse, if it is, the problem is given in multiplication, right? L inverse of 1 by s plus a into 1 by s plus b, how to solve? You need to solve using partial fractions. If it partial fractions are not possible, then we can go for this convolution theorem. Okay. So sometimes in the paper, especially he will ask you solve this problem using convolution theorem. That time also you need to use this convolution theorem and you need to solve the problem. Okay. Let us see one first problem, how to solve using convolution theorem to the given problem. See the first problem, what he gave here. Find L inverse of, see the first problem. Find L inverse of 1 by s plus 3 into s plus s minus 1. What is the first problem he says? Find L inverse of 1 by s plus 3 into 1 by s minus 1 using convolution theorem. If he says just solve, then what we have to do? You can solve this problem using partial fractions. Correct? Using partial fractions, we can say no. So let us see how to solve using partial fractions. L inverse of a by s plus 3 and b by s minus 1. That means this can be written as, for a, s plus 3 is equal to 0. For a, s plus 3 is equal to 0. S is equal to minus 3. If I substitute here minus 3, how much I get? Minus 4. So a is equal to what? Minus 1 by 4. Then for b, s minus 1 is equal to 0. S is equal to 1. So 1 by 4. So b is coming 1 by 4. So if my L inverse here. So 1 by 4 is common. So 1 by s plus 3 is what? E power minus 3t. And here e power 1t will come. This is the answer, ma. Correct? General answer. This is the answer, right? E power minus 3t minus e power. Without using convolution theorem, we got this answer. But now in this problem, what we need? You need to solve the given problem using convolution theorem. Correct? Using convolution theorem. Then in this, in that case, how to solve? When he's asking particularly using convolution theorem, so how to solve here? First, what we have to do, ma? So this problem can be written as, see here, let L inverse of 1 by s plus 3 into s minus 1 can be written as, okay, can be written as, how to write this one? L inverse of 1 by s plus 3 is one part, 1 by s minus 1 is one part, ma. Means I separated the given problem in two forms, f bar of s into g bar of s. This part is f bar of s and this part is g bar of. Your wish, you can take this one as f bar of s and this one as g bar of s. Our wish, ma. According to your convenient, you can take it whichever you want as f bar of s and g bar of s, right? Now this becomes f bar of s, ma. L inverse of, this is in the form of f bar of s into g bar of s. This is f bar of s, this is g bar of s, right? Now, what you have to find? You need to find L inverse of f bar of s separately. That means L inverse of 1 by s plus 3. L inverse of 1 by s plus 3, how much will give you? Will give you e power minus a t. E power minus a t, correct? So without learning the formulas of Laplace transforms and inverse Laplace transforms and inverse Laplace transform, you cannot solve even single problem in Laplace transform. I'm repeatedly telling you, please go through the formulas clearly. Learn the properties in Laplace transforms and inverse Laplace transforms. Okay. So L inverse of 1 by s plus 3 is what? E power minus 3t. But I need in terms of u, right? So what I'm doing here, e power minus 3u. In place of t, I am writing u. So this became in the in terms of u. So it is a function of u, f of u. Next, second part, L inverse of g bar of s. L inverse of g bar of s. What is g bar of s here? 1 by s minus 1 equal to 1 by s minus 1 will give you e power 1t. 1 by s minus a is what? E power a t form. In place of a, we have 1, e power 1t. So in terms of g of t minus u, I need. So in place of t, write t minus u. So this will give you g of t minus u. Clear? So we calculated f of u, we calculated g of t minus u. Now what we have to do? So therefore, by ct, ct means what? Convolution theorem. Don't write cd. By convolution theorem, L inverse of 1 by s plus 3 into s minus 1 is equal to what? One integral 0 to t f of u. What is f of u here? E power minus 3u into g of t minus u. What is g of t minus u? E power t minus u into du. Correct? We substituted the f of u and g of t. Now what you have to do? You need to integrate this part. You need to integrate this part. So this can be written as how to solve this. We are doing with respect to u integration, right? So t is a constant. Take it out, ma. That means integral e power t will come out. Integral 0 to t. Bases are same, powers can be added. E power minus 3u minus u will give you e power minus 4u into du. Will give you e power minus 4u into du. Now this is equal to e power t into integration of e power minus 4u is what? E power minus 4u by minus 4. Limits are 0 to t. So e power t by minus 4. If I substitute the upper limit t in place of u, these are the limits of u, no? So t, what I get here? E power 4t. If I substitute lower limit 0, e power 0. So multiply this one, ma. So what I get here? E power t, e power minus 4t, e power minus 3t. E power 0 is 1. I'll get e power t by minus 4. Like this, you need to solve this convolution theorem. Understand here? Earlier also, when we solve using partial fractions, we got same thing, right? E power minus 3t minus e power t by minus 4. Now here also, we are getting same answer. Unless, until, if he asks you in the paper, solve using convolution theorem, then only you will solve. Otherwise, if the partial fractions are not coming, he gave a little bit difficult, cube, square, something like this is given. In that case also, we can use convolution theorem, no problem, you will get full marks. Understand here? Like this, you need to solve the convolution theorem problem. Statement is very important, ma. Sometimes he will ask you statement for 2 marks also. What is statement here? If L inverse of F bar of S is equal to, if L inverse of F bar of S is equal to F of T, and L inverse of G bar of S is equal to G of T, then L inverse of F bar of S into G bar of S, L inverse of F bar of S into G bar of S is equal to what? Integral 0 to T, F of U into G of T minus U, du. So this is the first problem we did on convolution theorem. Okay, now let us see the another problem, how to solve using convolution theorem. Okay, next problem, second problem. Find L inverse of 1 by s plus 2 whole square into s minus 2. Find L inverse of 1 by s plus 2 whole square into s minus 2. Okay. So, how to solve this problem? See, if you want to solve this problem using partial fractions, you can solve. If in the exam, if he asks you solve using only convolution theorem, then compulsory you need to solve using convolution theorem only, ma. There is no other option, right? Now see the first how to write this one. Now we are solving this problem using convolution theorem. In convolution theorem, what we need? we need two functions, f bar of s and g bar of s, correct? So let L inverse of 1 by s plus 2 whole square into s minus 2 is equal to, how to write this one? A given can be written as like this also, you can write 1 by s plus 2 whole square is one part into 1 by s minus 2 is another part. 1 by s plus 2 whole square is one part into 1 by s minus 2 is another part. So this one I am taking as f bar of s and this one I am taking as g bar of s. Your wish, if you want to take this one as f bar of s, you can take. If you want to take this one is g bar of s, you can take. Okay, ma? According to our convenient, we can take. So, f bar of s into g bar of s. This is in the form of f bar of s into g bar of s, right? Now, what we have to do, you need to find L inverse of f bar of s, correct? So, this is equal to L inverse of, what is f bar of s? 1 by s plus 2 whole square, ma. 1 by s plus 2 whole square. This is in the form of first shifting theorem in inverse Laplace transform. So this 2 will come out in the form of e power minus at. This 2 will come out in the form of e power minus at. Then what is left here? S square is left. Understand here? Whereas in the Laplace transform first shifting theorem, we need to substitute in place of s, s minus a. Correct? In inverse may, what happened? This a will come out. If it is plus a, it will come out in the form of e power minus at. If it is minus a, it will come out in the form of e power at ma. Right? So, this 2 will come out in the form of e power minus at. What is left here? L inverse of 1 by s square. See, I am repeatedly telling you, go through the properties, learn the formulas, solve at least one or two problem on each property, what we are doing, what we are substituting, how we are multiplying property using, how we are division property using, then how we are solving partial fractions. Please go through. If your basics in Laplace transform are perfect, then you can play these all problems like football, ma. Okay, so e power minus 2t into this 2 will come out in the form of e power minus 2t L inverse of 1 by s square. So e power minus 2t into L inverse of 1 by s square is what? T. L inverse of 1 by square is what? T. Now we need in terms of u, no? So I am replacing t by u. I get minus e power 2u into u. This will give you f of u. This will give you f of u. Understand here? Now, next one, L inverse of g bar of s. L inverse of g bar of s. Okay? In the exam, write step 1. So, here I don't have a space. So, that's what I am writing like this. In the exam, what you'll do? You'll write like step 1. So, it will be more than one or two papers. Right? So, L inverse of 1 by g bar of s. What is g bar of s we took here? 1 by s minus 2. This is simple. L inverse of 1 by s minus a is what? E power at. So, I need in terms of g of t minus u. We need in terms of g of t minus u. So, to replace t by t minus u, you get in terms of g of t minus u. Correct? Now, what we have to do by ct? Ct is what? By convolution theorem. L inverse of what we need? 1 by s plus 2 whole square into s minus 2 is equal to integral 0 to t. What is 1 by s plus 2 whole square? What we got, ma? In terms of f of u, what we got? U into e power minus 2u. Then g of t minus u, how much we got? E power 2t minus 2u into du. E power minus 2t, e power 2t minus 2u into du, ma. Right? Now, what I am doing here, I am sending this e power 2t term outside because it is a constant. So, 0 to t, how to write this one? U into e power minus 2u, separate this power, e power 2t is one part, e power minus 2u is one part into du. Correct? We separated. Right? Now, so this is called what I get here, e power 2t is constant will come out, e power 2t integral 0 to t, u into, bases are same, this base and this base, powers can be added, minus 2u, how much will give you ma? Minus 4u. Right? So, this is equal to e power 2t into, this is uv form, ma. Which form? Integration uv form. Uv form integration u into, integration of this part will give you e power minus 4u by minus 4 minus minus differentiation of this part. U differentiation is what? 1. Again, this part integration e power minus 4u by minus 4 minus into minus 60 plus 4 into 4 16. Limits are 0 to t. Limits are 0 to t. Substitute upper limit, ma. If I substitute upper limit, what I get here? If I substitute upper limit here, So what I get here, so this is equal to e power 2t into LCM is what? 16 is LCM. 16 is LCM. If I substitute upper limit here, 4 4 is 16, no, minus 4t e power minus 4t minus e power minus 4t, correct? This is the upper limit. Then what is the lower limit? Lower limit is what? 0, no? So minus, minus, 0 into anything is 0, minus into minus plus e power 0 I get. So e power 0 I get ma, right? So therefore, this is equal e power 2t into e power 0 is how much? 1 minus e power minus 4t minus 4t e power minus 4t whole divided by 16. This is the our required answer. If you want, you can simplify, send it e power 2t inside, and if you want, you can leave it till there also, ma, no problem. Understand here how we did this problem using Laplace transform, using convolution theorem. Understand? So only thing is what, you need to take the given problem in terms of two functions. One is f bar of s, another one is what? G bar of s. So our wish, according to your convenient, you can take this one is f bar of s and this one is g bar of s, or this one is f bar of s and this one is g bar of s. Our wish, ma, answer will be same. When you take reverse also, answer will be same here. Don't worry, right? Understand here? So what we did here, we did UV formula here. U into integration of this part is what? E power minus 4u by minus 4 minus differentiation of u is what? 1. Again, this part integration e power minus 4t by minus 4. Already 1 minus 4 is there, minus into minus 16. Take the LCM, substitute upper limit in place of u, t, then lower limit minus half minus, this 0, 0 into anything is 0, minus half minus plus, e power 0 is 1. Understand? Okay, we'll solve another problem. Okay, next problem, find L inverse of 1 by s into, L inverse of 1 by s into s square minus a square, using convolution theorem. Find L inverse of 1 by s into s square minus a square using convolution theorem, right? So how to solve this problem? So given can be written as, so okay, one second. So this can be written as, let L inverse of 1 by s into s square minus a square, right? So how to write this one? L inverse of 1 by s, L inverse of 1 by s is one part. Otherwise, you take this one, s square minus a square is one part into 1 by s is another part. So this will give you, first one is what? F bar of s, L inverse of f bar of s, and second one is what? G bar of s, right? So now L inverse of 1 by s square minus a square, what will give you? It is a sin h a t by a. That means I need in terms of u, right? Sin h a, in place of t you need to write u by a. This will give you f of u. This will give you f of u. Next, L inverse of 1 by s, ma, g bar of s. L inverse of 1 by s is what? 1. There is no t here. So this can be taken as simply g of t minus u. Right. Now, what we have to do by convolution theorem? By ct, L inverse of 1 by s into s square minus a square will give you integral 0 to t. What is the formula? F of u. What is f of u? I got sin h au by a into g of t minus u is what? 1 into du. So 1 by a is constant, ma. Sin h au integration is what? Cos h au by a. Limits are 0 to t. Sin h au integration is what, ma? Cos h au by a. Limits are 0 to t. Correct? So substitute upper limit here. So a into a square, 1 by a square. If I substitute upper limit, I get cos h a t minus, if I write 0, cos h 0, cos 0. Cos 0 is how much, ma? 1. Cos 0 is how much? 1. So this is the answer for the given problem. Simple problem it is. Understand? So L inverse of, I took s square minus a square as f bar of s, and 1 by s I took it as g bar of s, ma. Okay? So see that. Next, we'll solve one more problem. Okay, next one, ma, important problem. See here, find L inverse of s by s square. Problem number 3, find L inverse of s by s square plus a square whole square. Find L inverse of S by S square plus A square whole square using convolution theorem. Using convolution theorem he is asking, right? So how to solve here? See, so I am taking directly here. Can I write like this? So given can be taken as L inverse of, this can be written as S by S square plus A square is one part ma, into 1 by S square plus A square is another part. So how I am writing here? S by S square plus S, don't write like this. You write solution, let L inverse, okay, like previous problem. So L inverse of S, this can be written as S by S square plus A square into 1 by S square plus A square, right? So this can be taken as F bar of S and this can be taken as G bar of S, correct? If you want, otherwise you can take reverse. This one is F bar of S and this one is G bar of S. Your wish ma, whatever you want to take, you can take L inverse of F bar of S into G bar of S. L inverse of F bar of S into G bar of S. Now, what I get here, L inverse of F bar of S, right? So, L inverse of S by S square plus A square is what? Cos AT. What is that? Cos AT. I need in terms of U. So, what I get here, cos AU, this will give you F of U. Next, L inverse of G bar of S. L inverse of G bar of S is equal to L inverse of 1 by S square plus A square ma. 1 by S square plus A square is what? Sin AT by A. Sin AT by A. Correct? So, I need in terms of T minus U. Sin A of T minus U by A will give you sin AT minus AU by A. This is what? G of T minus U. This is what? G of T minus U. So, we calculated F of U and we calculated G of T minus U. Now, what we have to do? So, therefore, by CT, by convolution theorem, L inverse of S by S square plus A square whole square. L inverse of S by S square plus A square whole square is equal to L inverse of, what is formula ma? F of U into G of, why are you, why L inverse? Sorry ma, integral 0 to T, F of U. What is F of U? We got cos AU into, what is G of T minus U? We got sin of AT minus AU by A into DU, into DU, right? Now, how to integrate this part? This is in the form of cos A sin B. This is in the form of cos A sin B, multiply and divide by 2 here, 1 by 2 into 2. What I am doing here, multiply and divide by 2, multiply and divide by 2, correct? So, this A will come out, 1 by 2 A, integral 0 to 2, 0 to T, 2 cos A sin B will give you sin A plus B, AU plus AT minus AU, sin A plus B and minus, correct? Minus sin A minus B, minus sin A is what? AU minus B, minus AT plus AU ma into DU. This is the formula. Sin A, this is A and this is B. A plus B minus sin A minus B, right? So, now here see, AU and AU got cancelled. 1 by 2 A integral 0 to T, I get sin AT minus sin of AU plus AU, 2 AU minus AT into DU, right? So, sin AT is what ma? Constant, no? We are doing with respect to U here. So, sin AT is constant. 1 by 2 U into integration of sin AT is what? U sin AT, because it is a constant. So, 1 will be there. Integration of 1 with respect to U is what? U minus sin integration is what? Minus cos, minus of minus plus cos of 2 AU minus AT. By chain rule differentiation of 2AU minus AT, U is 1, I get 2A. Limits are 0 to T. Limits are 0 to T. Correct. So, now substitute the upper limit. Ma. If I substitute upper limit, so what I get here in place of U, you have to write T. So, T sin AT, T sin AT plus cos of in place of U, write T, no? 2AT minus AT by 2a minus, lower limit is what? 0. 0 into anything is what? 0. Plus into minus, minus cos of minus at by 2a. Cos of minus at by 2a. So, now what I get here? This is equal to 1 by 2a t into sin at plus 280 minus 80 is how much ma? 80 by 2a minus cos of minus theta is what? Cos theta only, cos a, or a t no here, t, right, cos of 80, cos 80 by 2a. So, this part got cancelled. I get t into sin 80 by 2a. I get t into sin 80 by 2a. Understand here? So, like this, you need to solve this given problem using convolution theorem. Very simple topic. Only the thing is what? You need to separate it in the form of f bar of s and g bar of s. Then find L inverse of f bar of s separately and find L inverse of g bar of s separately. In replace t by u and here replace t by t minus u. That's it. Then both will substitute in the formula. Then integration. Integration is what? Already you did so many problems integration. So integration will complete it. You will get the answer. Understand? Take down. We'll go for another problem. Okay. Next problem, very very important problem. See here, find L inverse of s square by s square plus a square into s square plus b square. S square plus a square into s square plus b square. Okay. Right. How to solve this problem? So like previous problem, this one also you need to separate it into two forms. This can be written as L inverse of s by s square plus a square is one part into s by s square plus b square is one part. Correct? So, you can't separate it and you can't directly apply the formula, right? So, so many students in hurry, s by s square plus a square is cos a t, cos and this one is cos b t, answer is over, they'll write. It's not like that, no? So, you need to solve this problem using convolution theorem, right? Very, very important. So, this one can be, take it as L inverse of f bar of s into g bar of s, ma. L inverse of f bar of s into g bar of s, right? Now, see here. So, first what you have to find? L inverse of f bar of s. That means L inverse of s by s square plus a square will give you cos a t. Correct? Cos a t. Now, in place of t, what we have to write? U. So, cos a u ma. This will give you f of u. This will give you f of u. Correct? Now, second one, L inverse of g bar of s. What is g bar of s we took here? L inverse of s by s square plus b square, this second part. So, this will give you cos bt. So, cos b in place of t, I am writing t minus u. This became into g of t minus u, right? So, my first part is over. Now, I converted f bar of s into g bar of s form. I calculated separately L inverse of f bar of s and L inverse of g bar of s. So, after that, I replace t by u. I got f of u and I replace t by t minus u, I got g of t minus u. Clear? Now, what we have to do by convolution theorem, you need to substitute here, right? So, therefore, by convolution theorem, L inverse of s square by s square plus a square into s square plus b square will give you integral 0 to t. What is the formula? F of u. In the exam, write the formula, then next step will substitute. Here, I don't have a space. Okay, that's what I'm substituting directly, ma. So, L inverse of f bar f of u is s square by s square plus a square into s square plus b square is equal to integral 0 to t f of u. What is f of u? I got cos a u into g of t minus u. I got cos of multiplying ma bt minus bu bt minus bu into du. Understand here? Now, how to integrate this part? So, here multiply and divide by 2, multiply and divide by 2 ma. I am multiplying and dividing by 2, multiply and divide by 2, okay. So, it converted in the form of 2 cos A cos B. Which formula it is? 2 cos A cos B. What is the formula of 2 cos A cos B ma? 2 cos A cos B formula is what? Cos A plus B plus cos A minus B, correct? 2 cos A cos B formula is what? Cos a plus b plus cos a minus b. So, therefore, this is called 1 by 2a integral 0 to t. 2 cos a cos b will give you cos a plus b. What is b here? Bt minus bu plus cos a minus b. Minus bt minus of minus plus bu. Correct? Into du. Now, integration. If I integrate here, if I integrate with respect to If I integrate with respect to u, so what I get here, 1 by 2 u integral 0 to t cos, okay, sorry ma. So therefore, this is equal to 1 by 2 integral 0 to t, 1 by 2 integral 0 to t. So, acha, we are integrating, no? If I integrate here, so what I get here, if I integrate, 1 by 2 is constant ma. Cos integration is what? Sine of au plus bt minus bu by sine of au plus bt minus bu. Differentiation of au plus bt, u is 1a, this is 0, we are doing with respect to u minus b, correct? A minus b. And here cos integration is what? Sine of au minus bt plus bu by differentiation of this part is what? U is 1, a I get, here there is no u 0, u is 1, I get b. Limits are 0 to t. Limits are 0 to t. Understand here how we did this problem. So now what we have to do, you need to substitute the upper limit and lower limit ma. So if you substitute upper limit, 1 by 2 upper limit t in place of u, sine of a t plus b t minus b t by a minus b plus sine of a t minus b t plus b t by a plus b. This is upper limit ma. Minus, if I substitute 0, lower limit in place of u, 0, 0, what I get here? Sine b t by a minus b minus sin au 0 bu 0 minus bt sin minus bt by a plus b, correct ma? So now this is a little bit big problem. So now what we have to do, see this at and at got bt and bt, no, this bt and minus bt got cancelled, and here minus bt plus bt got cancelled, right? So, sine at, sine at. If I take sine at common here, so what I get here, 1 by 2 sine at, if I take common, I get 1 by a minus b plus 1 by a plus b, right? Now, here sine of minus bt is how much? Minus sine bt. So, minus of minus plus I get here. So, plus, if I take sine bt common, I get 1 by a plus b minus 1 by a minus b ma. So therefore this is equal to 1 by 2. So sine at, if I take the LCM here, a minus b into a plus b, LCM is what? A square minus b square. So 1 into a plus b, a plus b plus 1 into a minus b, a minus b. And here plus sine bt into, if I take the LCM, plus sine bt into, if I take the LCM, what I get here? Sine bt into LCM is what? A minus b into a plus b, a square minus b square, correct? So a minus b minus a minus b. It's coming up? Yes, it came exactly. Understand here? Now what we have to do? Now see here. So therefore this is equal to 1 by 2. B and b got cancelled ma. So b and b cancel. A square minus b square is what? LCM. So for both a square minus b square is LCM, b and b got cancelled, a and a 2a sin at, and here minus b minus a and minus a got cancelled, minus b minus 2b, so I get minus 2b sin bt by a square minus b square. 2 and 2 take out common, I get a sin at minus b sin bt by a square minus b square. This is the our required answer. So a sin at minus b sin bt by a square minus b square. Understand here? So now if you want, you can suppose if this problem is given in terms of some constant numbers, instead of a and b, if he gave you in terms of some numbers like 4, 5 in place of a square, if you have 4, if here b square 25, so a will be b, 4 means 2 and b will be 25 means 5. So if you substitute here, you will get the answer, but you cannot do like that. You need to solve the full process, then you need to simplify ma. Understand here this problem, how we did this problem. So using convolution theorem solving is very 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 important ma. Definitely most probably we will get one question from this convolution theorem topic. Understand here, this problem is very, very important. Solve this, these all problems very carefully. You will get the perfect in this topic. Okay. So, in the next class, we will see applications to ordinary differential equations. We will solve a few problems in that topic. Then we will see the previous year questions. Ma. Okay. Practice these all problems. We will meet in the next class. Thank you.